Why do we tell ourselves no if God hasn't told us no? The reason why we tell ourselves no is because we base that no off of what somebody else has planted in us. If somebody tell us, no, I don't think you should be doing that because of such and such and such, we be like, they might be right. Or if someone says we won't be able to do this because of such and such, we tend to roll with that no. No means it's a negative answer or decision. If God hasn't told you no, then why is everybody else's no okay? You have to be strong enough in you and what is inside of you that you know needs to come out versus worrying about somebody else's no. Sometimes people tell you no because they're afraid of being left behind. Sometimes people tell you no because they wish that thing that you're about to do that they would be doing. If you think about in the Bible, Barnabas, he was blind and he wanted to be healed, and he would be outside and he would be saying things, and he knew that Jesus was coming. So he kept speaking and he kept saying, Jesus, heal me, Jesus, heal me, Jesus, heal me, paraphrasing. And people was telling him to be quiet. People was telling him to shut up, in other words. If he would have listened to those people when they told him to shut up and stop speaking and stop calling out for Jesus, he would have missed his healing. If he would have stood on their no instead of God's yes, he would have missed his healing. If God ain't telling you no, stop accepting a no. If God is not telling you no, stop accepting a no. Because it is going to be people that's not going to agree with you and what you want to do. And that's okay. But if God ain't telling you no, stop accepting a no. And stop letting somebody else's no becomes your no. Because if God has already given you the push to push past they no, push past your fears, and trust God's yes.